time now for Sunday Brunch, and joining us this morning is Chef Mark Miranda from the Rusty Scupper. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm well, thank you. How are you?
I'm great.
Well, it already smells good in here.
Yeah.
Because you've got lots of butter.
Lots of butter, a little bit of oil, some blackening seasoning.
Okay.
For today's dish, we're going to be doing a Chesapeake rockfish, which we serve at the Rusty Scupper.
Yes.
It's one of the staple items.
Okay, so you're going to blacken it for us today.
And this is a native piece of rockfish, or if you're from any other place up and down the East Coast, it would be called a striped bass, but here in Maryland we call it a rockfish.
Okay, so that's a nice piece of fish, Mark, and it looks like you told me the key to this was pure butter. So first of all, you dipped it in the pure butter,
yep.
And then what kind of seasoning did you use?
We actually use a Paul Perdue blackening seasoning,
okay,
at the Rusty Scupper.
All right.
So we then dredge it into the blackening seasoning. And a couple keys to it, like you said, is the whole butter. Another thing is you want an extremely hot skillet.
Okay.
A lot of people use a cast iron skillet, like mm-hmm. Mom used to have.
Right.
Which works the best. Then all you do is you would place it, the flesh fish down first,
okay,
as opposed to the belly side.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're flipping it, you get the nice color, and when it's done cooking, that's a piece that's obviously going to be going onto the plate itself.
What kind of oil are you using?
I'm actually using a blended oil.
Okay.
So it's a vegetable oil with a little bit of olive oil.
Okay.
Olive oil tends to burn a little bit faster, so you want to have a blended oil at least. And actually, some people put a little bit extra oil in the pan, some people won't.
Okay.
Then after you cook it off, you got a nice blackening piece on the top.
It's cooking
here.
Quickly. It doesn't take long at all, does it?
No, and a lot of people, that's a fallacy that people make. I've got to cook it 10,
mm-hmm.
20 minutes for seafood.
Mm-hmm.
You probably need maybe 5 or 10 minutes.
Okay. So how do you know when it's done? It's hard to tell from the outside because it already looks done to me. It already looks black.
It's going to break away. Like,
okay,
if you put your tongs or a knife in it,
uh-huh,
it'll break away so the piece of meat, you can actually see it come apart.
Okay.
So this isn't quite done yet.
Okay.
Then at the Rusty Scupper, what we do when we finish this piece of fish is we'll top it with a little bit of jumbo lump crab meat.
Mmm, delicious.
Yeah, and we finish it with a Delmarva sauce, which is a spin on lemon butter. We actually mm-hmm. take a little bit of fresh basil, tomatoes, and of course the staple in Maryland is Old Bay.
Of course.
So we finish it with the Delmarva sauce. And it's probably one of our top, I'd say, 5 seafood items that we're serving at Rusty Scupper.
Well, I can attest. I was there last weekend for Jazz Brunch, which is so much fun. And this was absolutely delicious.
Thank you.
With so many people coming through, somehow you kept it fresh. And
that's hot. It
was delicious.
Yeah, and like you said, we do a Sunday brunch every Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
Father's Day was a little bit busier than normal,
mm-hmm.
but we do, I think, probably one of the best brunches down at the Inner Harbor.
And what's bigger? Is it the breakfast items or the seafood that people come for?
I would say it's a combination. Then we have raw oysters on the menu.
Mm-hmm.
We have peel and eat shrimp.
Right.
We have omelets made to order.
Mm-hmm.
We have 2 to 3 different carving meats every week.
Do you have a cart to cart people out?
Actually, that's one thing that the
elevator.
General manager, Ed Presser, is considering. It's maybe a couple cards so we can wheel them out.
All right. Well, we are out of time, but I know that we're going to have you back at 9 o'clock to cook another dish. Meanwhile, if you would like the recipe for this, if you can't remember our blackening steps, you can check out our website, WBALTV.com, or